Excuse me.
Hey, do I know you?
Mr. I believe we've met.
Yeah,
at Gessler Park.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. Well, to be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, we saw you in the wagon train, crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
As my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
It's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is. But I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, an appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
is me, Charles Chatonnet, the painter.
Okay. What are you dressed up like that for?
I am a wanted man, persecuted for my art!
As bad as it is, I don't think that the art is the problem.
In Paris, they say leave, go far away! We will never understand you here! I say, I go to Saint-Denis! They say that is not far enough! It seems to me that they were right. But it doesn't matter. Now, I go to South Pacific. They always tell me the light there is perfect for my work.
So long as they weren't telling you that just to get you on the other side of the world.
Perhaps. It doesn't matter. Help me get to the next ship. They are watching the port, and I need a chaperone.
Okay, come on.
Oh. I'll tell you what happened. I can hardly breathe in this city.
Yeah, I kind of know what you mean.
Why, I thought I would find my way in a country founded by Puritans. I'd never know. I know those men. I shot them in a bar. Quick, behind here. Keep up, keep up. Follow me!
Please do not do that again. Now get moving, come on.
Martin.
So, wait. You ain't sold none of your work.
There is always a heavy demand for fresh mediocrity, but new kinds of brilliance. Not so much.
New kinds?
The whole interference. We go through there.
Going, pretty lady?
Anywhere you want, mon ami.
Oh, oh my goodness.
This way, to the end of the docks. Of life was to be liked, it would be very boring indeed.
I've developed the feeling the purpose ain't to be hated.
Hate, love, they are the same. I provoke, I challenge, I amuse, do I not? With my impropriety, a mediocre life is meaningless. A bold life, filled with art and truth, dirty truth, that is something that matters.
Well, it's good to know you got a fail-safe philosophy, at least.
How else could...
Look at you, pretty little thing!
Oh.
Hello, boys.
Come on. So long. If they don't like you in the islands, keep on going to the South Pole.
Ah, yes. I hear there the light is really fantastic. Au revoir.
Baby.
Thank you.
Mister.
Bayar bon.
Thank you.
tong tong teng tong teng.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. There's the files in the office above the refinery room. It's that window with the blind drawn up.
I see.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will they?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
You got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You could crawl under the fence or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'm gonna take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally.
If you are quick, you could climb into the back of that wagon. Otherwise, you'll have to sneak past the guard.
Train to San Denis.
Okay. Better get a move on then.
Selamat.
quieten yourself, friend. This won't take long. Danbury.
Yes?
I need some papers, my friend. Nothing important. A file. From head office.
You're not from head office?
Does that seem important right now?
No.
I need a file by the Leland Oil Development Company. The one about the oil near Wapiti?
I...
Ah, banyak kan.
Danbury. Think, man. Mind is a terrible thing to lose.
Danbury.
Such a nice floor as this.
Come on, Danbury. Speak.
It's here.
Good, Danbury. Real good. They'll give you a promotion for this. No, Danbury.
Danbury? You okay?
Tell the guard you're fine.
Yes, it's just... I'm working. All's fine.
Now stay quiet. My head office will send me back to get you.
Dia teriak ya kan?
Hey, hold it right there. Weapons on the ground and hands in the air.
Easy now, fellas.
Now, we won't tell you again.
I was happy to watch some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silent.
Thank you. You saved my life.
Thank you. I hope. Well, I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Here's your money.
Thank you.
Berapa kita dapat, Arthur? 250. Kenapa ada gangster?
Come on.
Duit-duit kita itu.